Our goal is to find better ways of determining what causes the color and the flavors and aromas of beers and wine, and how we can change that and better them.
I got started making my own wine and beer about 20 years ago. My brewing partner was a microbiology professor. He started teaching a class in applied environmental microbiology. And that got me to thinking about this hobby. I would like to better understand this process. Through research, we better understand what's going on.
In talking with Dr. Mark, we developed this idea. We are doing beer and wine analysis, and it could help further the industry and education of the chemistry of beer and wine.
How do you know if the grape juice that you're going to make wine out of is ready to make wine yet or not? If you make some beer, how do you know that it's the same as it was last time? You've got raw ingredients changing from year to year, but you've still got to make the same beer with a different crop of barley. How can you adjust your process? So it's quality control. What does a brewery need to know to make sure that they've got product stability, that they've got product uniformity? What do they need to measure? Instead of making them send it out for analysis to someplace far away that's going to take them a while, is there something that we can provide them on site? And then on the wine side, we've got a project going with Lee Lutz up at Black Star Farms, and he wants to know about the amounts of different chemicals in the grape juice and how that plays a role in the finished product.
The grapes and the soil provide nitrogen along with the other food that the yeast consumes to create the alcohol. The levels of the nitrogen available to them is what's important. So controlling the level of nitrogen that the ground can give and that the grapes can give ultimately changes and affects the flavors that the wine will have in the end.
And then can we analyze for the amount of nitrogen to see if fertilizing in a particular way or watering in a particular way or sunlight or soil have an impact on yeast available nitrogen?
There's obviously a lot of things inside the wine, and I want to test the amount of acids that are dissolved in the liquid. I inject them into this machine. The machine separates the different compounds. Wineries want to know what the difference is between those acids, the ratios, because tartaric acid will separate out of the wine and will form a haze in the bottom of the bottle.
What we plan on doing and what we're currently doing is stuff that no other research has been completed on.
We've got now relationships with Crankers and Black Star Farms, developing some relationships with New Holland. The other place where I see this going is I see it taking us in the direction of having a bachelor's program in applied fermentation.
Research is required for discoveries, new discoveries. Someone's got to be the pioneer. Someone's got to be at the forefront.
Scientific research leads to better products. As a society, should we really worry a whole lot about having a whole lot better wine and beer? I think so. I think we need better beer. You know, better beer is going to improve the economy. It's going to create people some jobs. It's just going to raise the standard of living. So that's where I see it benefiting. Better living through chemistry.